Hey students, it's Mr. Hager, and today we're going to talk about digital media and copyright. So what is digital media? Now, media is kind of a weird word because it's used in a lot of different ways. You may hear on the news that people think that some of the media is unfair or biased. That actually is referring to journalists and newspapers and television broadcasts, newscasts, etc. The digital media that we're talking about basically means the digital content. So what does content mean? That just means stuff. So the digital stuff that is published on the internet is what we mean by digital media. So that might be lots of different things. It could be text. So you text on your phone. That's text that you publish out to the internet. Might be posts on a blog, articles online, an email that you send out. Those are all pieces of text. Now, other things, maybe images, still images posted online, like a website, like an app called Instagram. You have images, still images posted on that. Video is moving images and audio. And it's also posted on the web, like YouTube is a good example of video media. And of course, last but not least, is audio. Those are sound files like podcasts, online music like iTunes or Spotify. What is copyright? So copyright is kind of a confusing law. I'll try to make it simple for you. This law protects the people who create media. So when you create something, you own the copyright. So let's, for example, let's say that you make some music. You hook up your guitar to the computer, or you use an app called Soundtrap, and you make some music, and you post it to your website. You automatically own copyright to that media. You have the rights to it. Nobody else can take that from you. Even though it's just a piece of music on the internet, is not a physical item like a bicycle or a car or something like that. You still own the rights to that piece of music, that media, and nobody else can use it without your permission. And as you can see in this digital age that we are in, with all kinds of things available, and it's so easy to copy things and share them, that this makes it kind of difficult. So let's quickly watch a little video about this.
In today's digital world, it's easier than ever to copy, paste, mashup, remix, download, and publish content. People's writing, artwork, videos, and images can be inspiring, but they're also easy to take without thinking twice. When people treat the internet like a free-for-all, legal and ethical situations can arise. That's why it's important to know about copyright and fair use. It will help you give and receive credit where credit is due. So what's a copyright? Copyright law protects your control over the creative work you make. It requires people to get your permission before they copy, rework, or share what you make. Most things that you find, download, and copy and paste from the internet are copyrighted. That doesn't mean that everything online is on lockdown and can't be used. It can, as long as you check who owns it, get permission to use it, give credit to the creator, buy it if necessary, and use it responsibly, then you're not stealing. Now, there are times when you can use a small part of someone else's copyrighted work without permission or paying a fee. This is called fair use. Fair use only applies when using content in certain instances: schoolwork and education, news reporting, criticizing or commenting, and comedy or parody. Specific guidelines, what we call the 4 points of fair use, must also be followed. First, you can only use a small amount of the work. Second, you have to add new meaning to the work to make it original. Third, you need to rework it and use it in a totally different way. Finally, you have to use it for nonprofit purposes. In other words, you can't make money off of your new creation. No matter what, It's a good idea to give credit to the creator of the work you use. It's just a sign of respect. So what should you do if you find something online that you want to use? As a rule of thumb, check who owns it, get permission to use it, give credit to the creator, buy it if necessary, and use it responsibly, which means judging for fair use. You're a creator, innovator, and inspirer. Think twice about your rights and responsibilities in our online culture, and then pay it forward.
So, as you can see, copyright is kind of a tough subject, and so let's talk about how that copyright applies to using a Crocker portfolio or really any kind of digital work that you do on your Chromebook that you are going to share out to the world. So that would be any kind of media that you're publishing out to the internet. So the best thing that you can do is to create the media that you use. Obviously, if you create it, you own copyright and you can use it. Second best is to use something called public domain. So when you go into a Google, do a Google image search, and I'll show you how to do that, you can search for things that are labeled for non-commercial reuse. And I will show you an example of that. So for example, let's see. So I went on Google Images, and searched for dog. I chose tools right here and labeled for non-commercial reuse. Non-commercial means that I'm not making any money off of it. And I am reusing it on my own. I'm publishing it out to the internet on my own, not for commercial use. So I have this picture of this dog, and I checked out where that came from. You can go to visit this page, and it's right here from this website called Pixabay. And you can see right here it says public domain, free for commercial use, which I'm non-commercial, so that's even better. No attribution required. That means that I do not have to give credit for this. I can just use it. So that's pretty cool. I have permission to use that piece. The third best is that you can give credit to it if it's like if it's a Creative Commons. So the third best is that you can give credit where credit is needed. So for example, a lot of things are copyrighted under the Creative Commons laws, and that's where you need to give credit. Or finally, you can ask for the person's permission to use it. So I know that this is kind of complicated. So what I'm going to do is talk about an example. So for example, I went on to Google Images and I searched for public domain and came up with this icon here. I searched for labeled for non-commercial use and I did find this image. And then I went and I checked out where it came from, and this is what it said on the website. This file is ineligible for copyright and therefore in the public domain. That means that I can use it. So what is the bottom line here? You need to be safe and responsible and thoughtful about copyright. You need to create things for yourself if that's possible. And if you want to copy something digitally online, make sure that you check the copyright and you use it appropriately. All right, take care, guys.